Hello, inquisitive viewers, and welcome to Science and Spirituality on Supreme Master Television. This week, we will examine evidence for the existence of visits to Earth by extraterrestrial beings, which is called the Ancient Astronaut Theory. Over the ages, many texts and artworks have described or depicted flying objects, showing that intelligent life from other planets have come to our world since time immemorial. For example, ancient Hindu scriptures mention flying machines used by enlightened beings or gods. The 3,500-year-old Indian epic, the Mahabharata, and even older texts called the Vedas, Puranas, and Ramayana all refer to Vimanas, or Rathas, which may be translated as flying chariots. The Ramayana's description of a Vimana that has a double-decked circular form, a dome, round windows, and moves like the wind with the sound of thunder or music is much like modern eyewitness accounts of UFOs. The following verses from this scripture provide examples.
From Book 6, Canto 123, The Magic Car. Is not the wondrous chariot mine, named Pushpuk, wrought by hands divine? This chariot, kept with utmost care, will waft thee through the fields of air, and thou shalt light unwearied down in fair Ayodhya's royal town. From Book 6, Canto 124, The Departure. Swift through the air as Rama chose, the wondrous car from earth arose, and decked with swans and silver wings, bore through the clouds its freight of kings.
The Mahabharata also states that Bhima flew with his Vimana on an enormous ray, which was as brilliant as the sun, and made a noise like the thunder of a storm. In another ancient text, Vimanas are divided into three categories: those that travel from place to place, those that go from country to country, and those that go from planet to planet. The following is an excerpt from a lecture by Supreme Master Qinghai, where she discusses the flying chariots described in the Ramayana.
There are many kings in the old time. We call them the golden wheel saint king or something like that, because he has a kind of carriage, yeah, golden carriage, which can carry him anywhere he wants. Perhaps a UFO, perhaps, yes. Perhaps it was UFO, yeah. Yeah, when you read many stories in India, like Rama, huh? It seems like in the old time, people get in touch with the UFO people, extraterrestrial, yeah? We'd fly with a chariot on the sky. So what else then? We didn't have any airplane that time, did we? I don't think so, huh? Or perhaps we did. And besides, with all this magical power, it must be the extraterrestrial people that they have encountered. You know, Rama and his wife and the lot, the company. And of course, look here, he has so many beautiful things. He has seven things. Seven. In China, this means seven. Yes. And this means six. Okay. Five and one. He has seven precious things in his life. The first one is a very beautiful, strong, magical horse, which can carry him 1,000 miles an hour. It must be an aeroplane, huh? What kind of horse is that? Ah, but it's red one. And then he has the beautiful white, like snow, elephant. And then he has a precious stone that in the evening, emits beautiful light, like the moonlight. So they don't have electricity, they don't need to. Yeah. And then he has a car, like carriage, golden. And then this one can fly him up to the sky. In India, old time. What could that be? Airplane or UFO? Do we have a car that go 1,000 miles an hour? Oh, a day? 1,000 miles a day? Okay? That must be the car. He has a car and an airplane.
Robert, or Bob Orell, Dean served in the US Army for 28 years, retired as a command sergeant major, and is now a world-renowned UFO expert. After working on top-secret military projects related to extraterrestrial visits, Mr. Dean began a quest to discover and disseminate the truth about our interplanetary brothers and sisters. During his time in the military, he read secret documents stating that the visitors to Earth were peaceful and had been coming here since the time of early humans.
The conclusion of the study was quite simple. Apparently, there is no threat. Apparently, the human race and the planet have been under observation and survey by several advanced extraterrestrial intelligences from the beginning of human history.
The Book of Ezekiel in the Holy Bible also contains an eyewitness account of a UFO sighting provided by the prophet Ezekiel himself.
I looked and I saw a windstorm coming out of the north, an immense cloud with flashing lightning and surrounded by brilliant lights. The center of the fire looked like glowing metal. The prophet then continues, "This was the appearance and structure of the wheels. They sparkled like chrysolite, and all four looked alike. Each appeared to be made like a wheel intersecting a wheel. As they moved, they would go in any one of the four directions the creatures faced. The wheels did not turn about as the creatures went. Their rims were high and awesome, and all four rims were full of eyes all around. When the living creatures moved, the wheels beside them moved, and when the living creatures rose from the ground, the wheels also rose."
Further evidence for early extraterrestrial visits to Earth can be found in ancient art, particularly religious works where UFOs are clearly depicted. Such images are called out-of-place artifacts, or upa.
Again, now this is a Baroque painting from, I would say, roughly the latter part of the 17th century. Now you can see very clearly it looks like Moses with the Ten Commandments, but I want you to look in the background there. What are those three disc-shaped objects with domes on top? I can tell you something of what I consider them to be. In the Dead Sea Scrolls, they refer to objects of that kind as the chariots of glory. This is a famous painting that's hanging in the galleries in Florence, Italy, in the famous Uffizi Gallery in Florence. This painting was painted by one of the great Renaissance artists, roughly in the late 15th century. I want you to look at this picture. It's again a scene from the life of the carpenter from Galilee. There's the Madonna, there's Saint John, the baby Jesus. The Madonna is in one of those positions where she's praying. This was done by a friar by the name of Filippo Lippi, I think roughly about 1480. It's beautiful. It's a religious theme. The Madonna, the baby Jesus, and Saint John. But look above the shoulder of the Madonna there. What do you suppose that is? Let's look at an enlargement in the lower right-hand corner. You'll notice that there's a man standing there with his hand up to his eyes, shielding his face. There's a dog beside him that's barking. They're looking up at this strange object. What in the world is an object of that kind doing in a religious painting that's 500 years old? And what was Fra Filippo Lippi trying to communicate 500 years ago in that painting. One of the reasons I share it with you, and one of the reasons I'm so delighted in this upart, this anomaly, is that the object you see above the shoulder of the Madonna there is an exact representation of the object that hovered over the beach at Bonai, New Guinea a number of years ago, at a mission school where the Reverend Gill and roughly 40 of his students rushed out to watch this object hover over the beach at Bonai, New Guinea, roughly for an hour.
Indications of interplanetary contact with Earth are also present in Egyptian artifacts from the time of the pharaohs. The helicopter and UFO hieroglyphics in the Temple of Osiris at Abydos are a famous example, and another is the image on the burial chest of the god Osiris.
I want you to look at that object. I want you to look at the flames coming out of the rear end of it. Look at the cabin up in the central part in the middle. Look at the shape of that. That's the chest of Osiris. That was found on a sarcophagus, on the wooden panel of a sarcophagus that was estimated to be first or second dynasty. This was found at Abydos in Egypt. And first or second dynasty put the age of this object roughly 2,800 years before Christ. It intrigues me. The chest of Osiris, in my view, is very clearly a runabout. It's a little anti-gravity ship of some kind. You can see the jets and the flame coming out of the rear.
But evidence of UFO visitations goes back even further. In 1994, 30,000-year-old Ice Age wall paintings were discovered in the Chauvet cave in southern France. The Chauvet paintings depict 13 different animal species, including woolly mammoths, wild horses, and bison. However, one of the images most certainly looks out of place.
I call your attention to some of the other objects there. Look at the circular objects in the upper left-hand corner. Look at the objects up in the middle or the center of that drawing. Look at some of the objects off to the lower right there. Disc-shaped, circular objects with legs on them. Now, what in the world could our Cro-Magnon or Neanderthal ancestors have been trying to communicate here? Now, the next shot or two you will find are from a French gallery that were put together by a chap by the name of Leroy Gourav. But I want you to look at number 11 up there. Look at number 10. Look at the dots behind number 10. Now, if that's as clear as it can be, in my opinion, the artist is communicating that that object was moving. But look at the shapes. Those shapes are identical to circular discs, UFOs, that have been photographed over American cities, photographed over Mexico City in the last 12 months. And these are on the walls of a cave in northern Spain, southern France, that are estimated at roughly 30,000 years. And our ancestors were pretty fine artists.
Thank you, Bob Dean, for offering us your exciting insights on UFOs and informing the public of humanity's past interactions with those from the stars. As the famous saying goes, history repeats itself, and thus perhaps in a time very soon in coming when our planetary consciousness is raised, we will be making daily contact with beings from other worlds and once again become closely connected with the rest of the universe. Wonderful viewers, we thank you for your company today on Science and Spirituality. May we all soon reach our full heaven-given potential.
Today's enlightening entertainment will be presented in Japanese with subtitles in Arabic, Oraxes, or Vietnamese, Chinese, English, French, German, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Persian,
Portuguese, Russian, Spanish, and Thai. みなさま、こんにちは。宇宙に存在する生物は地球人だけではないということは周知の事実です。他の惑星からのパワフルで慈悲深い生命体が何度も何度も地球に訪れました。私たち人類もまた他の惑星を訪れてきました。日本の元首相夫人鳩山みゆきさんは数少ない幸運な方の一人です。何年も前に出版された本、私が出会った世にも不思議な出来事の中で自らが体験した惑星間旅行について語っています。2010年10月の太陽が与えてくれる霊的な恩恵についてと題するビデオ会議で、スプリームマスターチンハイは鳩山夫人を支持する見解を述べました。
Is there a purpose that certain individuals have this travels and share about it?
Yes, there is a purpose. So that she can share. Because they pick some individuals who either can share it to the large audience so that we're more used to with the UFO and outer space people, so that we are not scared should they have to land on emergency basis.Or so that we even let them help us in case they have to help us, emergency-wise or any otherwise. Some are more open than others. Some can share more than others, you see? And some have a higher merit store, okay, for the planet. And I'm very glad that the First Lady courageously do this. Mm-hmm.Because coming from her, people might believe more than coming from you, for example. It's a high time, if you ask me, that she talk about the sun even. They are the children of the sun, they so-called children of the sun. Japan, Ribbon, you know?
Yes.
Beings from the sun.
Oh, wow.
Yes. They see, they originate from the sun, you see?So it's a high time she talks about some spiritual practice concerning the sun. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
It's good for her and for her husband. I hope she's vegetarian as well, vegan. She's blessed.
スプリームマスターテレビジョンは最近幸運にも鳩山みゆきさんにお会いすることができました。みゆきさんは2009年9月から2010年6月まで日本の首相を務められた鳩山由紀夫氏の奥様でいらっしゃいます。
本日はどうぞよろしくお願いいたします。
こちらの方こそよろしくお願いします。
日本のファーストレディでいらした鳩山さんが、私が出会った世にも不思議な出来事という本の中でご自身の魂が UFO に乗って金星の方に行かれたということを話されていたことが紹介されました。その時のはどんなご体験だったのか教えていただけますか。
そう考えたら楽しそうでしょ、
はい、
なので私はそういうふうに考えるんですけど、それは人によっては夢じゃないのっていう方もねいらっしゃるんですけれども、それはそれで私は自分では行ってきたと思っているし、あそこはすごいグリーンの綺麗なものすごく緑のあふれるような場所でみんなが真面目にお勉強してたっていうのが印象なんですけど、そこから帰ってきたらっていうかね、地球に、っていうかベッドの中にいたんですけど、主人が横で寝てて、いい夢見たのとか言われたんですけどね。
最も華やかな日本の首相夫人として名を馳せたみゆきさんは、後人として多くの分野で精力的にご活躍されています。かつて彼女は有名な女性だけの歌劇団宝塚歌劇団の才能あるアーティストでした。そのような華々しい雰囲気を持ったみゆきさんは健康的な料理法を提唱したり、人気テレビ番組の出演や霊的な雑誌に記事を連載したことでも知られています。彼女はまた楽しく愉快なライフコンサルタントとして世間から認められ、自らをライフコーディネーターと称しています。
普段から何か心がけていらっしゃることとか、ポジティブに生きるための秘訣みたいなものを教えていただけますか。
それはね、私自身の、に起こるいろんなこと、例えば人から見たらそれは大変なことだなとか、もしかしたら不幸だなとか、いろいろに見られるかもしれないけれども、私自身はそういうものを与えていただいたっていうことで、自分に大きければ大きいほど自分にそういう力が備わってんだなと思って、そういうものをクリアしていくっていう、そういう考え方でいます。
鳩山さんはご主人様とご一緒に毎日太陽を食べていらっしゃるということなんですが、鳩山さんにとって太陽とはどのような存在なのか教えていただけますか。
太陽がどういう意味があるかって言ったら、みんなが本当は太陽のおかげで食べ物をいただいたりとか、いろんなことができるわけで、よく太陽を浴びるっていうのは聞くけど、食べるは聞いたことがないって言われるんですけど、私は毎朝こうちぎって食べてるんです。それを以前ファーストレディの皆さんが集まった時に、どうやってんのって聞かれて、だからこうやって食べてんのって言ったら、OK 私もやるわとかいう方がいらして、で次にお目にかかった時にやってるよとかっておっしゃった方もいらして、やっぱり太陽はエネルギーの元だと思ってるのでね、私にとっては。だからエネルギーの元をいただくっていう感じですね。感謝の気持ちが湧いてくるっていうか、生かされてる自分に。
鳩山みゆきさんはかつて日本の精神世界の雑誌ムーに記事を連載していました。また料理本も数冊執筆し、健康に良い菜食に焦点が当てられています。
材料はやっぱり日本古来のそういう根菜類っていうんですか、そういうものを中心に、やっぱり体にはそれがいいし、自然にも合ってるし、こう自然のこの流れ、それを私たちがその自然の中からいただいているっていうことを実感しますね。
今国連や科学者なども地球温暖化を阻止するために肉食を控えることを人々に奨励しています。でまたポール・マッカートニー氏 のミートフリーマンデーのキャンペーンにより世界の著名人やアーティストなどが賛同して、その輪が大きく今広がってきていると思います。このような世界の動きに対してどのように感じられているか、お話しいただけますか。
それは多分自然な流れだと思うんですね。いろんな地球温暖化とかそういうのも、牛を育てる、一頭育てるのにね、自然を破壊してそこに牧草を植えたりとか、そういうようなことをしてきているのが私たちなんですね、今まで。なのでそれで地球のバランスがおかしくなったっていうことですから、ここで元に返すには私たちが気がついて、それで元の地球に戻そうじゃないかという一つのきっかけとなるのが、私はその肉食をみんなでやめようじゃないかっていうことだと思うんですね。徐々にでもそっちの方向に行けるような、そういうような食生活のスタイルになったらいいんじゃないかなと思っています。
今年の3月日本で起きました東日本大震災をはじめ、今の世界中のあらゆるところで大きな自然災害が多発しています。で自然災害というのはやっぱり今まで人間がしてきた自然や動物へのひどい扱いに対して何か大きな警告を発しているように感じています。鳩山さんの思いが綴られた地球家族の皆様へのメッセージをぜひ世界の視聴者の皆様の前で読んでいただけますでしょうか。
ありがとうございます。本当に今おっしゃったみたいに悲しい悲惨な出来事ではあるんですけど、みんなが気づく一つのきっかけになったんじゃないかなと思ってるんですね。で私このセンテンスを自分が書いたんじゃないんです。なんかなんて言えばいいのか、上から降りてきたっていうか、本当にこれは2分ぐらいでさーっとこう書かせていただいたっていう感じなんですね。なので私の文章というよりは大いなる宇宙の言葉と思って聞いていただけると大変嬉しいです。地球家族の皆様へのメッセージ。21世紀は愛の時代、女性性の時代、二極化の時代、いろいろと言われて迎えた21世紀。 そこでこの地球に住むことを選んで今存在する私たち家族、振り返ってみてお互いの家族を悲しませたり苦しめたりがどんなに多かったことでしょう。今も戦争する人、それを応援する人、飢餓に直面している人、反対に慈愛に満ち地球家族のために働いている人、どちらも良かれと思って行動を起こしているのであって気づく時の差がある。私たちはいろんな神という存在を信じている。大いなる宇宙に大いなる力をそれぞれがどう表現しようが自由である。イスラム教であれ仏教であれカトリックの神であれ、いずれも自分に力を与えてくれる存在の人と呼び方が違うだけで否定するものではない。ここでは神と呼ぶ。神は地球に存在する家族を完璧に作ってくださっている。そのことを思い出すだけでいい。空の上から地球を見たら国境線もなく一つだ。家族の皆様、今私たちは立ち止まり自分の存在役目を考えるべき時、世界で次々と起こる天災人災、すべて意味があって私たちに見せられそして体感させられている。地球上で次々に起こっている天災について考えたことがあったか。これは偶然に起きているのではないということに気づく時が今なのだ。どんなに科学が発展しても自然の前で私たちは赤ん坊のようなものと気づき、謙虚で無視の一人の人間として感謝する気持ちを思い出すだけでいい。日本の国はこの度大きな気づきの機会を与えられたと心得るべきである。他の家族はこんなに温かく協力的でいてくれることにただただ感謝するばかりである。偶然はないと先に申したが、国の思い人の思いが自然界の秩序を乱し、これは神の警告である。今こそ我欲ではなく友愛の扉をみんなと一緒に開けよう、気づくべし。そしてそうだと同調した家族の皆々様は地球を守るべく一人でも多くの人に伝える役目を神から与えられている。今こそ立ち上がろう、神のもとに集おう。国境もないのと同じで宗教も自分が信じる教えであればこだわることなく認め合う。それが私たちの本来の姿だ。ありがとうございます。
本日は素晴らしいお話をありがとうございました。
とんでもありません。
またさらなるご活躍を心よりお祈り申し上げます。
ありがとうございました。こちらのこそありがとうございました。きっと気づかれた方がみんな人に伝えていくっていう役目があるので、これからもだんだん広がっていくことを期待いたしておりますので、今日はありがとうございました。
チャーミングで生き生きとされている鳩山みゆきさん、貴重なお時間を割いていただき、大切なお考えや宇宙からの緊急メッセージを賜り感謝申し上げます。人類がすぐに調和のとれた慈悲深い生き方に目覚め、地球が直ちに銀河系に美しく輝く星になりますよう皆で祈りましょう。鳩山みゆきさんの対談の本、私が出会った世にも不思議な出来事は下記のサイトで入手可能です。www.amazon.co.jp www.7netshopping.jp/books。 啓発のエンターテインメントをご覧いただきありがとうございます。スプリームマスターテレビジョンの知恵の言葉を注目すべきニュースの後にご覧ください。太陽とすべての宇宙が毎日皆様を祝福してくれますように。 Thank you for your pleasant company today on Enlightening Entertainment. Now, please stay tuned to Spleen Master Television for words of wisdom after noteworthy news. May the sun and all the universe bless you every day.